Hi, I am Abigail Statler, an undergraduate senior in animal science at Iowa State University. Today, I will be discussing cross-fostering practices done on sow farms. What is cross-fostering? Cross-fostering is a management practice done on 98% of sow farms today. Piglets are moved to equalize litter size according to their birth weights in an effort to reduce pre-weaning mortality. Ideally, it is done between 12 and 24 hours following farrowing, keeping those piglet movements within the room they farrowed in. This allows piglets enough time to nurse on their own dam, but also moving them to a new litter before that teat order is established. This also reduces disease movement between farrowing rooms. Many may wonder why cross-foster. There are many reasons that you may choose to cross-foster piglets, some of the most common being as follows. The sow farrows more or less piglets than she has functional teats. The sow farrows a litter with high variability in piglet birth weights. For example, she farrows 9 big pigs with 2 or 3 smaller pigs in the litter. And then also savaging of piglets. This typically occurs during farrowing, which it's important to catch early and remove piglets if possible as they are born. These are the three that I will be focusing on for the next part of this video. As done in the industry, we start with counting teats. Before sows farrow, teat counts are usually recorded on the sow's card so that employees can refer back to it and know how many piglets that sow can support. As you can see, this sow has 12 functional teats. In this scenario, this sow only farrowed 9 piglets. We can add 2 to 3 pigs from a larger litter to complete her litter with 12. This is done by taking 3 piglets of similar size from a litter with too many piglets and placing them into the Duroc sow's litter. Once all movements for this sow are completed, you will make note on her card as well as the card you removed piglets from. This sow farrowed 13 piglets but only has 12 functional teats. Since most pigs in this litter are medium to heavyweight, we removed a lightweight piglet and moved it into a litter with smaller pigs. When cross-fostering to reduce variability, it is typically when only 2 to 3 pigs are bigger or smaller compared to the rest of the litter proportions. To solve this, we move those pigs into litters with pigs of similar size to them. These are exceptions where cross-fostering may occur after the first 24 hours of life. Weak and fall-behind piglets are typically identified around days 4 to 7, and they are treated and/or removed and placed onto a nurse sow, or if necessary, they will be euthanized. It is important that these pigs are placed into their own litter, as fall-behind pigs will decrease milk production due to their low consumption of milk. Sow death can sometimes be unavoidable. One of the common reasons for sow death is prolapse following farrowing her litter. If unable to disperse her piglets to other litters that have farrowed that day, a nurse sow would be brought in from that day's weaned sow group. Another common issue is a health-challenged sow who has a loss or slowed milk production. Depending on the age of the piglets and their proximity to weaning, a nurse sow could be utilized. If the room's health status is good and pigs are a day or two away from weaning, the dividing board between crates could be pulled so that piglets could nurse on neighboring sows. This will vary between different production systems. Here we are creating a nurse sow. A nurse sow can either be a recently farrowed sow whose piglets are removed on day one, or a sow who has weaned her original litter and adopted a new one. Because of this sow's small teats, she would be a good candidate for those small pigs removed from litters throughout the room. It is good to take into account the entire room's best interest for the highest chance at survival. We can do this by leaving smaller pigs on their own dam when possible and moving those larger pigs first, taking note of the health status of both the litter you are removing the pigs from and the litter you are placing the pigs into. Scours typically don't start until 2 to 3 days of age, which is another important factor to why we don't want to cross-foster later than 24 hours post-farrowing. And approximately 15% of piglets born are considered lightweight, whereas 40% are considered heavyweight. In summary, when implementing a cross-fostering strategy, ensure that both light and heavyweight groups are equally benefiting. It is best to complete cross-fostering within 24 hours of birth, and most of all, it is important to make the best management decisions for your farm based on your own farm's data and rules.